We're on location with the Beatles, and they're here to tell us about an exciting new movie. Say hi, fellas.
Hi, everybody. This is John here.
This is Paul.
George.
And Ringo.
And we're very happy to be on your program once again.
Tell us where we're talking from this time.
We're just talking on the set of the film we've just finished in Nassau. Bahamas.
Help!
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 John, where did this title come from, Help?
Out of Dick Lester's mouth it came. Our director and friends.
I thought it came out of his shoe.
Well, Dick sort of slowly went up to us one at a time, punching us, saying it's going to be called Help. And we said, yeah, that's a great idea, Dick, sir. We'll call it that, and that's how it all became about.
Why did you have so much trouble with the title, Paul? I know you had a different title first. What finally made Help the final title?
Because it was about the best, I'd say. Just sounds right, you know. That's why. You know, Help. There you are. It fits the story because, you see, people are trying to get us all through it, you see, and so we need a bit of help, you see.
That's right.
This second picture, John, how does it differ from the first one you made?
Well, it's in colour for a start, and I don't know, there's a lot more happening in this. There's a story, you see. In the last one, it was just sort of documentary, but this is a real film almost.
Do you have any different problems in this one, George, other than in A Hard Day's Night?
A couple of more problems. A couple of more, yes. Because, for a start, we had a big idol and lots of trick things, you see. Whereas we didn't have any trick things in the last film, did we, John?
No, we didn't, George. We didn't have any tricks in the last film.
Yeah, the business about the idol was that it was supposed to rise from the water, you see.
And it wouldn't.
As a sort of trick. And it wouldn't, because the water was always too rough for it. So we've had a bit of trouble with that.
Does this idol have anything to do with you, Ringo?
Yeah. I can't tell you what the plot is, but here's some of the questions that will be answered. Why were the high priests of the terrible goddess of Kaili interested in the Beatles? What did they want of him? They weren't fans. Two leading scientists hoped to rule the world. Paul was threatened by a beetle. B-double-E-T-L-E.
What happened to you in this picture, Ringo?
I'm chased by a gang of thugs all the way through it, actually.
Yeah, they seem to be chasing Ringo. And then there's two leading scientists who hope to rule the world. And an Eastern beauty saves our lives from time to time, it says here.
All I can say is, will John live to sleep in his pit again?
Right. Or, for instance, will Paul ever get back to his United organ? Electric organ, I mean.
Now, you're kind of veteran movie stars at this point. Do you like this business of making movies, Paul? Is it difficult for you?
I think all of us really enjoy it. It's something different, you know, and we've all forgotten about how difficult it was or how hard it was sort of standing around the set all day. You forget about things like that. And it's just nice to be sort of doing something like a film, which is a completely new thing for us, really. You know, we've only ever done one before this one. It's just good seeing rushes and seeing a film get together and seeing it sort of make itself, you know. Yes, very exciting. Lovely.
And John, this movie brings us more great songs from the Beatles, too.
Oh, well. There's about 7, not sure. And Paul and I wrote 11, and we chose 7 out of the 11.
I suppose there is a title song.
Yeah, it's called Help, you know. We think it's one of the best we've written.
Sung at the beginning and the end of the picture, made for United Artists, with the help of Walter Shenson and Dick Lester, one or two people we ought to plug, called Help.
George, how do you go with this movie-making career, and how do you take to this business of making movies, getting up early in the morning, getting the makeup and so forth?
That's a bit of a drag, getting up in the morning, but apart from that, and the waiting round, it's great fun. We have a great laugh, don't we, fellas?
Yes, we do,
yes,
George.
We do.
Yeah, it's great, upset as George said, for getting up in the morning. We hate getting up, you know. It's always difficult to do something you hate.
Especially when you go to bed about 3 in the morning, you know. It's very difficult to get up at 6. However, as we never go to bed at 3 in the morning, as we always go to bed at late evening. No, you know, it's difficult when you go to bed late. Some nights you do, some nights you don't. There you go, and there you are.
Ringo, you're a newlywed. What do you expect out of marriage?
What do I expect? I don't expect anything. I just love being married, you know, and I love my wife. And I just want her to be there all the time when I'm there, you know. Now, there's no one can say she can't do this and she can't do that. You know, if we want to go anywhere or do anything, you know, I'm the boss, we just do it. There's no one to tell us anything else now. It's marvellous, you know, because, you know, we both belong to each other. You know, and you can share everything, you know. It's a great thing being married. You know, I enjoy it. Well, I mean, I shouldn't sort of... I'm not an authority on it. I've only been married a month. But, you know, I enjoy it. I love it. It's something you can't explain, you know. It's only people who get married know this thing.
John, tell me, where has this taken you, this second Beatles picture?
Well, it took us to the Bahamas, Nassau, and we've been to Austria. That was great. And most of it was done in London, of course, which is also great.
George, do you like this traveling around to different places?
It's not bad at all when you're making a film.
John, does this traveling around and doing one-night appearances ever become a drag?
No, it's a drag. If there were no kids, I think it'd be a drag. You know, we'd say, what's happened? We'd say, how would we say it?
We'd say, what happened? There's not half as much excitement when there's just nobody around, you know. I mean, it's nice occasionally to get a quiet spell. For instance, like when we were in the Bahamas, you know, that was nice and quiet. And Austria, pretty quiet. But doing tours and things, you know, that's always more hectic. But it's still good. It's good in a different way. You know, like making films is good, and making records is good, but in different ways.
But there must be times when this hectic life gets to be too much. In fact, a recent article said you are even rude at times.
The article was right. We've been quoted as being rude to people. We're always rude back. You know, and we're no more cynical than we ever were. Just that it's, you know, people notice being cynical because we're sort of public figures, but we've always had the same attitude. We've always disliked the same kind of people as we did years ago.
But if someone comes up to us and is rude to us, then we'd be idiots, you know, just to sort of stand there and smile as they were being rude to us, you know. I mean, nobody's going to take that, and it doesn't matter whether you're a public figure or anything. You know, you're just stupid if you don't do something, you know, in return sort of thing. It's okay turning the other cheek, you know, but your cheek doesn't half get smashed up that way.
A woman came up and says, I've got a so-and-so year old daughter, but I couldn't care less myself. You know, something like that, she said. And I thought it was pretty rude, seeing as we were eating at the time as well, in the middle of a meal. So we were just a bit cold towards her. And she probably thought we had no right to be, but she forgets that we're human, you see.
At what point do you get used to a phenomenon like this?
At first, you know, everything was going too quick anyway. We didn't even have enough time to think of what was happening. We just did it, and then, you know, suddenly we realised that we were selling records and things. But, you know, apart from that, we never thought too much about it. You know, we used to just see how many records were selling, and that was it, go and do a show. But we never used to sit round talking about how great we were. So, you know, it's just a thing, you know, in the back of your head that you're what you are and you're doing your job and that's it, you know.
Now that you've completed your second picture, you boys are not going to give up concerts, are you?
No, of course not. We're doing a big tour, you know, in America. I don't know how many cities, but it'll be pretty hectic, you know. But it's all good fun. We enjoy it. Filming, making records, concerts. You know us. I laugh a minute. Ha, 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 ha.
When you're writing a song for the picture, do you write it for a particular scene?
What happens is that we just shove
them in anywhere.
Yeah, we just write the songs first and then just shove them in anywhere, as George said, especially in the sunset scene at the very end of the picture, where the two lovers, that's George and Ringo, are coming towards each other on the beach and they just finally meet. Well, actually, they don't quite meet. They just run past each other and both dive into the sand, and as they do, the sun goes down. Yeah, that's it. The sun goes down, and it's a sort of big facade of oriental beauty, you know what I mean?
That
sort of
facade Harbuckle.
And then the whole picture just ends up with them.
You're telling him too much about the story.
I'm sorry, I've told you too much.
They won't go to see it if you tell them all about that.
I've told them about the vintage car race.
The vintage car race?
No. Well, that's another scene where we all go from Brighton to Egmonton. And none of us win, unfortunately, and it just about ends there.
Sounds like fun. I want to thank all you boys for talking with us today. Good luck to John, Paul, George, and Ringo. We're all looking forward to seeing you in your second motion picture, Help.
This is Paul McCartney saying thank you very much. We hope you enjoy our film, and it's been nice being on your show.
This is John Lennon saying thanks for everything. Enjoy being on your show.
This is Ringo saying thanks for everything. Hope you enjoy the film and the songs from the film, and we hope to see you all when we come to the States.
And this is George saying goodbye to everybody who's been listening, and also to you for having us on your program. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
So long, everybody.